Live playing I've done in 2 years. What strange feeling. Thank you. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is just open this up by talking about this particular technique that I use, which is legato technique. So for anybody, is anybody new to guitar, or you've all been playing a while? Yeah, so you probably know what legato is. Does anyone not know what this technique is? It won't all be questions, I promise. I'm supposed to be here most of the time. Legato, just a real quick primer. So this is, it technically means smooth, although if there's any Italians in the audience, they will tell you it doesn't mean smooth, but kind of, when you learn classical music theory, legato, does it mean smooth, Jake?
Smoothly.
Jake's like the expert. The reason it's utilized as a technique is twofold. The first is it sounds very smooth. So it utilizes hammer-ons and pull-offs. So a hammer-on is where you execute a note using the left hand exclusively, and you hammer down a little bit like, imagine a piano hammer. If you've ever seen the inside of a piano, you get the hammer that comes down on the string, and you execute that with a press down on the key. Well, the equivalent with guitar, let me turn off my mountain of delay. I love delay. The equivalent on guitar would be to pick a note and then slam the hand down, the finger on the left hand, onto the next fret. Okay, so that's a hammer on. The pull off is in the opposite direction, where you would pull down away from the string. Now immediately, this to me is a slight misnomer, because I think of a pull-off. If you think of the term pull, you literally think of really aggressive pulling motions. My legato technique is very, very, very consistently smooth and relaxed, okay? It's not about brute force and ignorance, okay? My picking is about brute force and ignorance. It really is, because I've got no skill in that area at all. I basically clench my teeth and go for it. With legato, I should be able to, when I'm executing this technique, be able to talk to you at the same time. In fact, we can try that a little bit later. Because it's such a relaxed technique. So the hammer-ons and pull-offs give you a very smooth sound, because you don't get the pick attack. Pick attack is wonderful, because when we pick fast, or when we just pick generally, we get this transient, as they call it, at the beginning of a note. A little bit like when a drumstick hits a snare. There's this initial transient, and then just like a drum, the guitar is a very percussive instrument, and then the note dies away. But the transient is the bit that the pick really gives the character of, if you like. Whereas hammer-ons and pull-offs, it's a much smoother sound. When you chain these things together, you get this beautiful, smooth sound. So I'm presuming everyone in this room, I'm not going to play any of his stuff, but everyone is familiar with Joe Satriani. And he was my initial kind of, if you like, gateway drug, if I'm allowed to say that, into legato playing when I was younger. Him and a few other people, but he was the initial experience. And the way that those kind of, I'm going to use the term rock guys, but it's not meant in a kind of, I'm not trying to categorize anybody in any particular way, but he certainly is influenced by the rock school, or not influenced, he created that rock instrumental kind of sound. The way they approach legato is they use it as a textural device and a speed-based device. which I do too, but it's in a different way. So when you listen to Joe Satriani, if you think about, does everyone know Flying in a Blue Dream? It's a stunning piece of music, and there's this amazing, after the initial melody, when the solo kicks in, I'm not going to play it because I can't quite remember it, but it's a little bit like... And he describes it as like, if you imagine liquid metal, mercury, for instance, rolling around in the ball of your hand, probably not a good idea, but I think it's quite poisonous. But if you roll it around in the ball of your hand, it's got this liquidy sound to it. But the really important distinction here is not the technical application, it's the time rhythmic-based application. So if you've ever bought or looked at any of the transcriptions of Joe Satriani, Steve Vai, John Petrucci, Paul Gilbert playing legato, you'll see if you tried to actually count the rhythms out, they're a nightmare. You'll see a bunch of notes and then like six above, and then in the next beat you've got eight notes, and then the next beat you've got 15 notes. Because if you listen here, there's no like pulse to this. Again, if I... It's a texture. It's fast, and it's textural, and it's smooth, and it's got this beautiful sound to it. At least I think it's beautiful. It's a really beautiful sound for the instrument. That is not the way I use legato. The technical approach is identical, but the way I use legato is based on a rhythmic structure. So when I say rhythmic structure, what I mean is, if you just imagine, if I said 16th notes to you, to use an American term, or semiquavers, to use a British term, if you think of dagga 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 dagga, there's the beat, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. We tend to articulate that subdivision, as it's called, of the beat, as 1 E and A, that would be beat 1, 4 sounds, and then 2 E and A, 3 E and A, 4 E and A. So you've got 16 sounds in the bar, hence 16th notes. This doesn't sound like a subdivision. That is, I'm thinking about subdivision. The thing with legato is that most guitar players find is when they practice legato, they'll do this. So if anybody's ever sat with, I don't know, like Terrifying Guitar Trip by Paul Gilbert, or Rock Discipline by John Petrucci, or any of these guitar DVDs or VHS tapes back in the day when I was looking at them, one of the exercises you'll learn is to take something like this. And what do you do with it? What's the goal?
Speed up.
To get fast, with no perception of what the subdivision is or the timing, just the goal is. And you just go for it, and you grit your teeth, and the vein pops out the side of your head, and you're like, yes, I can play it fast. But then someone asks you to play it in time, and almost all guitar players fall to pieces, because it's really hard to do this stuff in time. When you pick, you've got this inbuilt metronome in the right hand. I'm going to pick now, you're all going to walk out. If you pick, just something really simple. Hopefully you can kind of hear that I'm accenting the first group of four, or the first note of every group of four. So da ga da ga da ga da ga da ga da ga da. So if you were to play a scale, like if I played a G major scale. You can hear da ga da ga da ga da ga da ga da ga da. With legato, when you do it fast, you don't have the option to accent every fourth note. Nobody in this room, even the mighty Alan Holdsworth, when he was alive, rest in peace, he couldn't do this either. Because what happens is the guitar is not designed, stringed instruments are not designed to give you even subdivisions without using this, the pick. Because every time basically hammer-ons and pull-offs sound different to pick notes. Okay, so if I pick a note, I get that transient that we talked about earlier. If I hammer on a pull-off, I still get a small transient, but it's nowhere near as loud. The front of the note is nowhere near as loud as the pick. So what happens is every time I change string, I get this accent that pops out. So you get this weird thing where, as a guitar player, I tend to arrange my scales with three notes on each string. And we get this. It's not a group of four, that's a group of three. I always have to be careful what I'm doing here, but the group of three is not created because I wanted a group of three. It's created because I got an accent every time I changed string because I was picking the new string. Because unless I hammer on with my first finger, which people do, that's a very unusual technique to utilize for this kind of playing. Every time I change string, I get that group of three. And it gets even weirder at the top because I get this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 group and then threes again. What you end up with is, this is a lot of bass because it's on this sound, I apologize. What you end up with is, it sounds like a guitar player falling down a flight of stairs. Because we get this. And all of these accents are popping out all over the place. Now playing a group of three over a group of four that you're perceiving is super cool. If you listen to Frank Zappa, if you listen to Wayne Krantz, these guys do this all the time, but they're doing it because they want to do it and they mean to do it. If you're doing this and those string transitions, the string changes are popping out all these accents all over the place, you're not in control of it. And that's the difference. You should be in control of those accents. So what we do for legato is, we don't worry about the accents, we just remove them as much as possible. So if anybody's ever played one of those old Moog or Moog, however you pronounce it, synths, or a harp, no one in this room has probably played a harpsichord. That would be weird. Maybe you have, maybe you've got one at home. But if you play a harpsichord, they don't have any volume changes. It doesn't matter how hard you hit the key, the volume is always the same. Now, in music generally, this is a bad idea. When you play, you absolutely... you want accents. That's what music is all about. It's about contrast. Loud, soft, you know, fast, slow, so on and so forth. But when you play these legato lines, these subdivision-based legato lines, you do not want those accents popping out. So what you've got to do is minimize the volume difference of the string changes to the accent, to the hammer-ons and pull-offs. And the way I do this is I use the middle finger on my right hand, again, got to be careful here, the middle finger on my right hand to execute those string changes, and I brush the string really lightly. So instead of this, you get this. Sounds totally different. Suddenly you can perceive dagga 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 da. If I do it again. So you absolutely want to be in the position where you can remove those accents from those string changes. And again, you can either do it with the pick, and you can pick as softly as you can across those string changes. You can do this with a clean sound as well. It doesn't have to be distorted like this. If I go like this, hopefully it's not too loud. Oh, there's the delay again. I apologize. Okay, so. Okay, so on the way up, I'm using my middle finger for each new string. Experiment with the pick if you want. Just keep the string accents down. And then on the way down, this is known as hybrid picking, by the way, if anybody's ever checked that out. Hybrid picking, I use it all the time, using the pick and the middle finger. On the way down, I can't hybrid pick backwards. I can't do it. It just doesn't work for me. So if anyone's come across sweep picking, I sort of do mini sweeps. So basically, I pick up and then rest on the next string. Pick up, rest. And it's the resting that's really important, okay? And I kind of prepare each string change. So basically, my starting position is, if I'm going to play this 3-note per string scale, my pick is on the low E, and my middle finger is already on the A string. I'm not having my middle finger floating in midair, because that makes no sense. So it's already on the A string. I go pick, hammer, really lightly. Pick, hammer, hammer. Middle finger, really light brush. It wasn't... We're not playing country music, as cool as that is. So... then hammer, hammer, and while I'm doing these hammers here, my middle finger has already moved to the next string, the D string. So it's this. You have to, the really weird thing is, don't watch this hand, because you all know what's going on here, hammer-ons and pull-offs. If you can see it, watch the right hand. It's hard, because of the guys at the back, you definitely can't see this, but I can demonstrate this to anyone afterwards. So it's middle, sorry, pick, hammer, hammer, middle, and then the middle finger is now already on the D string. Hammer, hammer, middle, already on the G string. Hammer, hammer. So you get... I'm going to go to the next one.